The state of Texas has been in the throes of a severe drought since 2011, the driest year in the recorded history of the state. But here on the South Plains, where agriculture contributes tens of billions of dollars to the economy every year, the water woes may start with the clouds, but the issue goes a lot deeper.
The southern high plains sit on top of the Ogallala aquifer, an underground reservoir that is the largest groundwater system in North America, extending into 8 states. More than 90% of the water pumped from the Ogallala is used for irrigation, necessary for the livelihoods of crops and producers on the South Plains.
Crop production is very important in the economy here. Upwards of 30 to 35% of the jobs in Lubbock alone depend directly or indirectly on agriculture. And agriculture is a very high value industry here. Water is extremely precious here to our economy. There is a lot at stake here.
For our agricultural industry that uses most of the groundwater in our region, in most places where people are irrigating, we use the water faster than it's replenished into the aquifer.
When it comes to the aquifer, it is one asset that could soon dry up.
This is an aquifer that has very limited recharge, if any.
When we use the water faster than it gets back into the aquifer, it means that someday, in some places we're already there, and we'll be short in other places soon as well. Irrigated agriculture will end in the southern high plains of Texas, probably within my children's lifetime, unless something changes, unless crops need a whole lot less water.
That is exactly what some researchers at Texas Tech University are focusing on, creating farming innovations in crops and irrigation that will increase water efficiency while decreasing the groundwater footprint.
And we're also using that opportunity to teach farmers about the innovations that are out there now for improved varieties, ways to monitor the soil water content, ways to schedule irrigation so that the irrigation water is more efficiently used.
Most of my research is focused on trying to get more water use efficiency out of the crops that we're growing. The major crops that we grow here on the southern high plains include cotton, corn, and sorghum. And what we're trying to do is to get more crop per drop. We're trying to get more yield with a limited amount of water.
Richie tells us these special water-efficient breeds of corn, cotton, and sorghum don't waste water or energy on excess growth, so they tend to be shorter and mature more quickly than other varieties.
Another area researchers are focusing their attention to is improving irrigation efficiency.
Since agriculture uses about 95% of the water pumped from the Ogallala aquifer, that becomes a very important target, you might say, for conservation.
This is subsurface drip. It's supposed to be about 95% efficient, so nearly every drop of water that goes into the soil is going to be taken up by the plants.
When you look at an aerial view of the South Plains, it is a green patchwork quilt of center pivot fields. Researchers say some farmers are now dividing that circle into pie pieces to irrigate more efficiently.
A circle may have 2 different crops. It may even have 3 or 4 different crops. Perhaps one side of the circle has been turned into a pasture, and you might have cattle growing on that part. You can shift that peak water use from this half of the circle to the other half as the summer progresses. And so both crops are not needing all the water at once. So there is, you might say, more diversification going on of the crops. And we like diversification because then that gives the producer more choices.
Wes says the water situation has left some farmers choosing a completely different crop, one used for livestock.
Some people have even switched back to growing grass crops, to growing grass that's used for producing seed or for producing forage that gets grazed by cattle. The nice thing about the grasses is that they generally use less water than our major row crops.
Drought or no drought, and whatever the method, researchers say area farmers are ready and willing to do their part to conserve our precious water.
So they're changing their planting density, they're changing their row spacing, they're switching to more water economical varieties, and they're really trying to dial in on something that's going to work best in their situation.
So it's important to learn from droughts. As we say, you know, never let a good drought go to waste. So I don't think we let that drought go to waste.
Whether the optimist sees the Ogallala is half full and the pessimist sees it as half empty, the realist knows it's a precious resource we must conserve. For KTTZ Texas Tech Public Media, I'm Lacey Nobles.